Hi guys, Jamie here, back again with our update on our airport fire truck, the 8x8 Simba. Plus, I have two group builds coming up, one with Keith and one with Russell. I've got the kits here and I'll just show in a second. But anyway, fire truck, we got all the interior cabin built up, dashboards in, steering wheel, seats, and so forth, all the glass works in. Glass work, it's not very clear, it's a bit cloudy in places, but I polished it up as best I could. A bit more painting in around the back, letters, and those here vents had to be done black, so it was just easier to do it all white first, and then I'll just mask away up. We still have two orange marker lights to go in here, and the other side there's six lights in each pocket here that goes in. There's a big box goes in behind this here, and slides down in behind it and glues up tight, and there's a grill, steel grill to go over this. But in the center of that there's a circle, you can just about make it out. There's a big fan goes under that. So I have a wee motor left on side, a wee stepper motor, so it'll spin when everything else is on, engine's running and so forth. We've got our speaker box in. I have another one there to go in as well. One's for the siren, one's for the engine. Don't want to turn them on together, so we've got two separate speaker boxes. So the same ones that I've used in the Harley-Davidson police bike I built there a few months ago, the 1/6 scale Tamiya. So the same exact same box. So there's plenty of room inside there to install the rest of the stuff that it needs for the lights and so forth. Still a pair of lights to go until. I've only got the marker lights in now at the minute. Still they add all the blue flashers and so forth. The toolboxes are going to begin in today at some stage with the shutters, they're all done silver. The whole roof's done silver. All the mud flaps, they have to go on. I think they're done black. Just have to double check. The front end here, we have two water cannons. They're made to pivot in and out, so they are. There's a smaller one for the opposite side. They'll be painted up. There's another big water cannon goes on top. This here actually does spin. It's a bit stiff on it. I'll just take a wee shaving of it. Front end here is made open and close, as I think I said that in the last video. Just got this painted this morning, so unlettered. Bit of a nightmare masking this all up, to keep it all white, those wee lines and so forth. So that's made to go in to the front here, so I can get it to go in to smack it up again. So it goes in the front, and then the roof goes on. Then this opens and closes. There you go. Then the roof goes on, as I said, and oh, and on all our wipers and so forth. So there's four wipers on the front. I haven't put the windshield in just yet. On just down the bottom, we can just about make it out. So we can get a wee pointer here. I'll use the blade. This is made to open and close the door. There's two spotlights goes onto that. There's two spotlights down below as well. Plus there's four headlamps on. Sorry, two headlamps on either side. I have two beacons to go on the top here. I have one wired. I have another five to do. The decibels, as I said, our previous. There's a different choice. There's Munich and there's Germany. One or the other. To choose from, I'm going to go for the art, but bone, what's up with the one that's on the box art? I think it's more striking. Still to do the full roof, it's done silver, and it up the edge of the roof is when it tapers out. It's done white, same as the back end there, just done that white this morning. Done those late last night, the letters. The runners themselves are like done like a bright red, so I'll do them all towards the end because we're going to use enamel paint on it. It's a bit of a higher gloss shine on it. This shutter has been done silver, so on the opposite side that has been done silver as well. Trying to get this color to show up on camera, it's difficult because it's like a fluorescent, it's actually a fluorescent orange, but it looks red, even in person looks red. That's the color there. I was going to do it to fire red, but I seen this colour here and I thought it was going to be more striking against the white and the decibels and so forth. Still to do those tyres. Keep putting those on, putting them off, because I want rolling chassis at the minute, so it's easier to work with. So I'll cast them tires towards, maybe towards near enough towards the end of the build. I'll get them on, because those tires are actually a really bad fit. So they are, and no doubt during time it's going to sag, because it is quite heavy, more so up at the front end of it, because there's a lot of plastic and so forth up at the end of it here. I'll try and get a better shot off the cabin later on. I'm gonna put another video up, but it's nicely detailed. Plenty of decals on the dashboard, so there is. Still, they add the cabin lights as well. It's another thing. So still a good wee bit off yet this build. I'm happy enough where it's turned out so far. I have no major problems just yet. Touch wood. It's the roof. It's a bit worrying on it because, as you can see up the side of it here, it's a bit out of shape, so we might have to add a brace across to pull it in tight before we drop the roof down on it and glue it in place. This side here is not too bad. So there you go, this is where we are. But anyway, let me get this out of the road first and we'll show what's coming up here on the two group builds. The Halloween group build, which is Russell's model cars and Keith's models and RCs. That's coming up very shortly. So I'll get this out of the road and we'll show what kits I have for it. Just bear with me. So the first one we have here for the group build is Keith's RCs, models and RCs, sorry. It's the BMW Z4 GT3 from Studio. I got this a few months ago. It's a really nice kit from Fujimi. Like the decals on it, it's going to be really striking against the white. No engine in this one at all, so it's a curbside. So again, hasn't been started, so we're looking forward to this one. The next one is from for Russell's Halloween build. I had this again for a few years, about 2 years maybe. And it's never been around to building it, but now it's the time and it fits the issue for Halloween theme. So it's Christine from AMT. AMT models are gonna be touch and go for me. Last one I built in the AMT was the bigger scale, the 16 scale Chevy Bel Air. I built that over about a year ago or so. Wasn't too bad, but it could have been better, but anyway, off topic here. But this is up next, so we're doing this Halloween theme, and I'll probably do it not as pristine as this, nice and clean and so forth. I'll probably weather it down, and a few other things I'll probably add to it. Headlights, I'll be doing them either red or green, and same for the cabin lights. I'll probably do them red or green, I don't know just yet. Tail lights, I'll probably do just keep them red. But there you go, guys. Two builds coming up, one with Keith and one with Russell. So they'll be starting very, very shortly. Well, Keith will be starting shortly. Russell's is in around start of Halloween, I think. Not too sure. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. So again, I want to thank all them subscribers that jumped on board there recently, and all my new subscribers, all my original subscribers, sorry. Really do appreciate these guys. If you weren't there, I wouldn't be here at the same time. So I really do appreciate it, all your support and feedback. But anyway, guys, don't ramble on too much. It's gone on now, almost 9 minutes. So thanks for watching. We'll speak later. Shami signed off. Bye.